Hello everyone, I'm Rachel from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library, and in today's Tinkershop tutorial, we're going to learn how to create large welcome signs using Inkscape. Let's get started. Begin by opening up your Inkscape program. In the middle of your screen, you'll notice a square, and this is known as your canvas. Anything you design inside of your canvas will be captured by the program. Anything that's outside of your canvas will not be captured by the program. So let's get started. I always usually like to measure my actual piece of wood that I will be gluing items onto and then proportioning it to that size. So the first thing I'd like to do is change my document properties, and that's changing the size of the canvas. I'm going to go up to the File button and I'm going to click on Document Properties. A new window will appear, and in this drop-down menu right here, instead of millimeters, you can click IN and that'll be in inches. If my item is 1 feet by 3 feet, we'll have to put in those measurements. So my width would be 12 inches by 36. Okay, so I'm gonna close my window, and right now you can see your canvas has changed quite a bit. It's nice and long. If you wanna adjust that, just go back up to your document properties and you can make it longer if you wanted to. Okay, so right now we know that our piece of wood is about this length. It may not look it, but virtually this is 1 foot by about almost 3.5 feet. Next, I'm going to go over to my text tool and I'm going to start typing in what I would like it to say. I'm going to hold down my shift button so everything will be capitals. To make your font bigger, go up to your move tool and click on the arrows and drag it to make it a lot bigger. Now, if we want our letters to go vertically, just hit the Enter key in between all of your letters. Let's make this a little smaller. And you do have the option to stretch out your letters as well. I like to always try to center my letters. So what I do is I'll go back to my text tool. You'll notice the menu changes up top here, but I'm gonna hit the center option. We can see right now everything's all centered. And as I'm just kind of putting it into place, even though that's not gonna matter too much later because we will adjust it to fit a sheet of wood, I wanna change my font. I'm gonna go up to this T at the very top. I'm gonna click font. And this will bring up just a variety of different fonts. It should show you a preview, however, it is a little bit big. You can shrink it down if you'd like. So it'll kind of show you in the preview window. And then in this menu here, click and you should be able to see previews of what your font style will look like. Do try to stay away from extremely thin fonts, but when you're doing it this size, there is a lot of wiggle room. When you find a font that you like, just click Apply. And it will change your text. I'm gonna make this a lot bigger again. And it's looking real good. Okay, so if you wanna add some decorations maybe to the side, you can also cut those out. I like using leaves, or around the holidays, you can change the O out and have different symbols. But if I'm gonna look for something, I wanna look for either silhouette, something thicker, and I'm gonna go to Google Chrome to do that. I'm going to look for a leaf outline. And as you can see, there's quite a few. I'm going to select this one and I'm going to copy my image. I'm going to go back into Inkscape, right click and hit paste. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to trace bitmap this. So I'm going to go up to the path menu. I'm going to click trace bitmap, click update, and click OK. So there's two right now. Now, how do you tell which one is the image you just brought in and which is your vector file that you'll be using for laser cutting? If you click on your other image, it'll block out your actual design on the canvas. Now, if you click on the image you just traced, you can see it has a transparent background, and that's the one that we want to use. So I'm gonna click on my other image I just brought in and I'm gonna delete it. Now, I would like this design to be engraved, And then I want to have like an outline just cut around it, but I don't want it to cut on the inside. And there is a way to do that. I'm going to make a copy. I'm going to right click and hit duplicate. I'm going to bring one over. So now I'm going to go up to the path menu and I'm going to click the option break apart. And what this does, it breaks it into different shapes. You can see one shape here, but I'm looking for the silhouette shape. Now it's all blanked out and that's because it has a fill. And a fill is actually engraving. So this item here too also has a fill, but it's just these lines. I want to turn this into a cut line. Go over to Object and click Fill and Stroke, and a window will appear. For this option, you don't want the infill color. Click Stroke Paint and hit the solid square, and now you can see it's just the outer line of this. And this is where you can control and set your cut line. To make it a little bit bigger. So I would like it to be kind of a border over my leaf. And if you find that this is being an issue right now, you can also do a thing called dynamic offset. I'm going to go up to the path menu and now click dynamic offset. You'll see a tiny little dot here. Click and drag, and this will kind of expand it around your shape. And I'm just going to make my leaf a little bit bigger on the inside. I'm going to click my outer line again, and this time under stroke style, I'm going to type in 0.001. in inches, and that'll make it cut. Okay, you can barely see it, but there is a cut line around here. So I'm going to select all of my objects for this leaf, and I'm going to group them together because when I move it around, I want to be able to make sure my cut line is still there. It doesn't look like it, but if I zoom in, you can see this very faint line around my object. So now I can shrink it down. And I can start moving it around my leaves here. I can start kind of designing it, and I can hit duplicate again. It should duplicate the engraving and the cut line. If you go up to the top here, you can rotate it, you can mirror it, you can flip it, but have some fun with that. So we're going to make a couple of them. And if you want to, you can rearrange them and resize them to give some more variety. And you can also add in different leaves if you wanted to, just by following those same steps. Okay. Now, this is just a simple way of showing different items, but let's get our designs ready to fit on one sheet of wood for the laser cutter. So I'm going to have to go back up to Document Properties. And I know that a sheet of wood is 24 by 12 inches, but I like to put in 11.5 just in case if it's not cut straight. Okay. Now, your letters here are still known as text. We want to turn these into an object so we can place them now onto our sheet of wood. And then we'll insert it to be a cut line. So go up to the path menu and you have to turn this into an object now. So now this is just one object and it'll have the same features as an image where you can change the fill and stroke. So go up to object and this time we want to ungroup our text. And now this should be just a whole bunch of separated letters. So now within this sheet here, you might have to do two sheets. You just want to place it so they all fit. And you can rearrange these however you want so they will fit for your design. Again, just have fun with this. Get comfortable with the program. And the best part is you can rotate these because it doesn't matter. You'll be gluing them on separately. Okay, so now lastly, we've already set the cut line for our leaves. But I want to set the cut line now for our letters. So I'm going to hold down Shift. I've selected my letters. I'm going to go back over to my Fill and Stroke menu, and I'm going to click the Fill tab, remove the inner fill, click the Stroke Paint tab, and now you can see there's just the outline. And then we're going to go Stroke Style, and again, put in that magic number, 0.001 in inches. Looks like things have disappeared. Go down to your Edit Path tool, and you can kind of hover, and you'll start to see just the outlines in red of what your cut lines will be. Finally, We're going to save our design. So go up to the File menu, click Save As, and I'm going to save two different versions. I'm going to save the SVG version, and I'm going to also save a PDF, just in case I have to go back and edit it. So I'm going to select just Inkscape file, click Save, and now I'm going to save it a second time. So File, Save As, and click PDF, Portable Document Format. Hit Save, click OK, and now you've just learned how to make a large welcome sign using Inkscape for the laser cutter. These are great gifts. They're also wonderful for making signs for a nursery, for birthdays, even a housewarming gift, or even for anniversaries. We want to see your designs, so when you have completed them, please send us pictures, and be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all the newest Tinkershop tutorials. Again, I'm Rachel from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library, and thank you so much for joining us. Take care.